Hello and welcome to this latest video. First, I apologize if my voice doesn't sound too good. I've been sick, but I'm good now, and hopefully my voice will be able to last through this video. So let's get this started. Make sure you give this video a like, as that will help get this video more views. If you could do that, it would be awesome. We just had EU elections, and there's been a right-wing wave sweeping across Europe. Despite all the mainstream media pushing a far-left agenda and conservatives being censored on social media, the right wing had huge success this election. Nigel Farage won in the UK with over 30% of the votes. Nationalist Marine Le Pen beat globalist Macron in France. Salvini won with over 30% of the votes in Italy. Viktor Orban won with over 55% of the votes in Hungary. In Sweden, the right is surging. The Swedish Democrats got the biggest increase since last election. In Poland, conservatives won with over 40% of the votes. And in Belgium, the right-wing nationalist Vlaams Belang Party came in second place in the national elections. The president of Vlaams Belang, Tom van Grieken, said, quote, "This election was about our people, and our people have to come first." Unquote. Nigel Farage's Brexit Party even became the joint largest party in the whole EU Parliament. Just imagine the face of the EU elites when Farage comes marching in through the doors of Brussels with a massive grin on his face, declaring, "I'm back!" This is the biggest comeback in the history of comebacks. And think about it, the UK shouldn't even have been in the EU elections to start with. They should have left already, but the politicians have kept them still in the EU. So the people said they had enough and voted accordingly. And we see the same across all of Europe, the people being tired of the elite and voting for right-wing parties. Salvini, for example, recently warned that Italy should not become like Sweden, saying, quote, "We don't want to end up like Sweden, this is not integration," unquote. But the Swedish embassy responded claiming that there are no no-go zones in Sweden. So what do these results mean for Europe then? Well, the EU elections are not like general elections. Instead, this election decided which parties will be represented in the EU Parliament over in Brussels, who in turn make laws like the infamous Article 13. EU elections are usually not taken as seriously as natural elections, hence why fringe parties have had a tendency to do better in EU elections. Now, the way the EU Parliament works is that different parties form groups together, so different parties from across Europe form groups together based on how close they are together politically, I would assume. There are three kind of right-wing Eurosceptic groups in the EU: the ECR, the ENF, and EFD groups. In the preliminary results, together they actually got 171 mandates, meaning they could have been the second largest group in the EU after the centre-right EPP group. But of course, these 171 mandates are split among these three different groups, who are the ECR. They are mildly Eurosceptic. You have the ENF, which are right-wing nationalists, and you have the EFD group. The ENF group, for example, includes Salvini's Lega Party and Marine Le Pen's party. As you can see, the right has gotten a lot of votes in this EU election. In fact, the biggest winner was the ENF group, who went from 0 to 58 mandates. But this election clearly shows that people are not happy with the status quo, and that seems like there's a general feeling across Europe. How long can the EU be sustainable without going through major reform? Rich countries are paying in enormous sums of money to keep poorer countries going. Countries like Germany have been paying in loads of money to support the poorer countries like Greece. Almost a little socialistic, A lot remains to be seen as what will happen to the EU. So what do you think about the EU election, guys? Was it what you hoped for? Let me know in the comments below, and make sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this video all over social media. If you like this video, please consider supporting me on Subscribestar. Unlike the mainstream media, I rely on you guys to help me keep producing content like this. Check out my Subscribestar page and see the perks you get for subscribing to me over there. I'll leave a link below. Also, make sure to follow me on Telegram to get daily updates on what is happening. I'll leave a link to that below. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Head over to my website petersweden.com and sign up to my email list to get all the latest news, independent news, uncensored news. So make sure to sign up there. And also, if you want to support my work, it's highly appreciated. Head over to my donate page, because I need your help, guys. The mainstream media are not up to job. They've got billions in funding. I've only got you guys. So if you want to support my work at all, that is highly appreciated. You can support me on Patreon, where you can do a monthly donation and get different rewards as well, depending on how much you want to support me with, and get access to exclusive posts. Or you can do a one-time donation on GoFundMe if you'd rather do that. Anything is highly appreciated and helps me keep going and producing quality content like this for you guys. Thanks so much. And now a huge thank you to my special Patreon supporters. I couldn't have done this without you. I really appreciate your help, guys.